Hello, I'm Daniel, and welcome to the Curiosity Shop for January. Now, as you can probably tell, this episode's a little bit different. There is no footage of me traveling around different stores looking for thrifting. The reason for that is that it's winter, and it's kind of hard to get around and go thrifting and that sort of stuff at this time of year. So what I'm going to be doing this year is there'll be one episode of these every month, and if I don't go thrifting, it'll just be like me going through the games that I've gotten in the last 4 weeks, and if I have gone thrifting, you'll also get all of that at the beginning, and you'll be able to tell which episodes are which, because the ones that are just me talking about the games that I've picked up, they will say January pickups, February pickups, or whatever, and the ones that actually have me thrifting will have a different title, something a little bit catchier, so you'll always be able to tell before you actually click on it, in case you don't like these ones as they are. Aside from that, just a little bit of housekeeping. I know this channel's been quiet. Aside from this series, the only other thing I'm planning on doing on this channel this year is to celebrate Pokemon's 20th anniversary, I'll be doing a Nuzlocke challenge of Pokemon Red, Fire Red, which I've never actually played before. I've played the original, you know, Red a million and one times. I've never played the Fire Red version of it, so I'm pretty excited about that. It'll all be a legitimate capture through a GameCube with component cables, so it should look really, really nice. And that's something I'm pretty excited to do, probably starting in the next few weeks. So yeah, keep your eyes open for that. Now, for what people actually clicked here for, the gaming pickups that I got in January. I will say I cheated a little bit with this. Some of these games are actually from December, but because I didn't go thrifting, I hadn't actually made a video out of it. And that was before I decided to do things this way. So there's a couple of games here, not many, but a few of them from December. So let's get into it, shall we? And we'll go system by system. All right, so my first system of choice here today is the Game Boy. It's not a system that I really collect for. I'm kind of just seek out games that I remember liking. I'm not really looking for a full Game Boy collection or anything like that. But someone from work was selling off some of his Game Boy games for a good price. We will get to the GameCube later. And I picked up two of them. The first of which was a Castlevania Adventure. This guy here, Castlevania Adventure. Not a good game. Certainly considered one of the worst, if not the worst, Castlevania game ever made. But it was a dollar, so I wasn't going to say no to it. You know, there are definitely still worse games out there than this. And the second Game Boy game I picked up is something I'm much more familiar with, and that is Metroid 2, The Return of Samus. This is a game that I owned myself when I was very young. Battery in it still works. It's a little bit stained, but yeah. A lot of people don't particularly like this Metroid game either. It's not necessarily bad, it's just very linear compared to what people expect from the Metroid series. A lot of that was due to the limitations of the Game Boy. Personally, I enjoy it quite a lot, but that's probably just nostalgia glasses. But hey, it did come with the manual, and I love the like, if I just whip one open here, like the designs of like the aliens and stuff in this manual are just, when I was a kid, I would just like look through this like over and over again, because I loved this stuff. So those are the two Game Boy games that I picked up, and I think these were actually the ones that I picked up in December. So yeah, it's not often I pick up games for that particular system. And speaking of Nintendo and the GameCube, I only picked up one GameCube game this particular month, and that was Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles. I think I bought it off a guy for 20 bucks. I still need to clean up the, there's a little bit of stickers and stuff on this, which needs cleaned up, but it's full with a manual and everything, which is awesome. For those who don't know, I'm trying to get a full GameCube set, and it's something that I kind of slowed down on in the last couple of months. I'm not going to get into the reasons why, financial mainly. But this is a game that me and Jess were both talking about, and I've never actually played it, though I did play the sequels on the original Nintendo DS. And I know some people really don't like this game, some people really like it. Obviously I haven't played it, so I don't have an opinion on it, but I am looking forward to giving it a go and finding out just exactly what it's like. Because even though the second game on the DS wasn't particularly good, I really enjoyed the first Crystal Chronicles game on DS. And if it's anything like that, I mean, I should have a good time, because I quite enjoyed that. The next system would be the PlayStation 3. Most of the rest of these purchases came from EB Games, a place that I try not to buy from, but because I haven't been thrifting, I have been getting a few things from there lately. The last generation stuff is finally starting to come down, and especially on the PS3, a lot of the first party PS3 games are like $5 now. So it's been pretty hard to say no to those. So first of all, we have a God of War 3, which I have previously owned and I traded in many years ago, but now that I'm collecting, I kind of wanted a copy of it again. The only God of War game I don't have a copy of now is Ascension, I believe. Yes, Ascension. So I remember really enjoying this. This one I paid $9 for, which is more than I probably should have, but I was just kind of going through a thing at the time. I recently just played through the original God of War again. Pretty soon I'll probably play through God of War 2 again, and then I want to play through this, so I picked up because, yeah, I quite enjoy those games. The two other games I picked up were games that I haven't played before. Some of you may remember a couple of months ago I picked up a copy of Killzone for the PlayStation 2 for a couple of dollars, and because of that, when I saw these two games on sale for like $5, I believe they were $5, yes, $4.50 each, I had to pick them both up so I could experience those as well, so I can play through the trilogy. I know there is a trilogy version that has all three of the games, but I haven't seen it around, so. Anyway, those of course is Killzone 2 and Killzone 3. As I said, I haven't played any of the Killzone games yet, but they're those sorts of exclusives I hear people talking about a lot, so they must be alright, surely. right? Yeah, so I'm looking forward to finally seeing what these games are like. I'm really interested to see what Guerrilla Games' new game looks like. That caveman science fiction game looks kind of cool. But yeah, it'll be interesting to finally go back and see what the Killzone games are like, because I really have no idea, but I've always kind of wanted to play them, but for whatever reason, just never got around to picking them up. So it's good to finally have, now I have the whole trilogy, I have all of them except the PS4 one in my collection, so that's pretty cool. So speaking of last gen, as many of you know, the Xbox 360 is still the console that I probably put the most hours into, which is kind of hilarious because I do have an Xbox One, but I spent a lot more time playing my Xbox 360 for whatever reason. And there are plenty of cheap 360 games. Most of them are third-party games. There are definitely ones out there. And usually if I just see any 360 games, if they're like $5, I'll pick them up. So last month I picked up, well, first of all, Dead or Alive 5. I played Dead or Alive 4 quite a bit when that came out. Haven't played 5 yet. I don't know that I will play 5, but it's there just so it's in my collection. It was $4.50, much like Killzone. So I was gonna say no to that. I think it's actually cheaper than Dead or Alive 4, which is kind of strange. Yeah, that was just one that I picked up purely because I, you know, collecting, and the price was right. Then we have a really good deal, which was Rainbow Six Vegas 2, which was only $2.70. Now, these are actually cheaper because Rainbow Six Siege was just coming out, and something that they're doing here, I don't know if this is happening in other countries as well, but here in Canada at least, EB are doing deals where when a game in a series is coming out on the current gen systems, the last gen versions they're putting up for like really cheap. So in order to promote Rainbow Six Siege, they were selling Rainbow Six Vegas and Vegas 2 for like $2, $3 each. So I already had the original Rainbow Six Vegas, didn't have the second one, so I picked that up. And for $2.70, I know this game's supposed to be really good. So yeah, that's a really good price, hopefully for a really good game. Now the next two games I paid a little bit more than I would have liked. That said, like they were still really cheap. But I picked them up because I'd never seen them before. And when I see a game that I've never seen before, I kind of feel obligated to pick it up because I never know if I'm going to see it again. And that's why I grabbed the next two games. So first of all is Infernal Hell's Vengeance. I looked this up after I bought it. I'd never heard of it. And apparently it sucks really bad. I couldn't find any reviews on YouTube or anything. Maybe like a couple, but they were like really bad, low quality reviews. So I'm glad I grabbed this because it's not particularly common. It was $7, which is, you know, more expensive than a lot of the good games I bought. But as I said, it's a, you know, a publisher I'm not familiar with, it's a game I'm not familiar with, and so I had to pick it up. And, you know, like, I have a penchant for bad games, I find bad games fascinating, so I'm looking forward to seeing just how bad this is and what makes it so bad. Because when I can't find information on a game, that intrigues me. And along the same lines was Morph X. Now, this game's price ticket was removed, I think I paid about $6 for it as well. Once again, never heard of this game before. The publisher, 505 Games, has done some games I'm familiar with. All I know about this game is that it's a science fiction game set in Russia, which is immediately intriguing. I found that out afterwards because I didn't really read the back. I just picked it up and said, what the hell is this? I gotta grab it, so I did. But I know it's a science fiction game set in Russia, and I believe, I could be wrong, but I believe it was also developed in Russia by a small Russian team. It was actually released as a budget title, and you know, like I said, when I see something I've never seen before, I grab it because I never know if I'm going to see it again. And once again, this game is actually pretty uncommon, and there's like next to no review content on YouTube, so very, very intriguing having mysterious little games like this. So yeah, can't wait to see what this is about. But these weren't the big deal. These weren't the big deals of the month. No. We got a really good deal, and this is that really good deal here. This is a game called Inversion. And you're saying, well, that game's pretty mediocre and it's not rare, why was that a good deal? And the reason is because of the price we paid for it. Yes, that's a goose egg, that's a zero. Now, I was at EB with my friend Paul, who you've seen occasionally on the show, and he found this actually, he was digging around and he was like, $0. I actually wasn't originally going to pick it up because I thought I had it, but the game I thought it was Fracture. But yeah, he just picked it up because he wanted to see. if you took it to the counter, if it would actually be $0 because it was a misprint, and they'd be like, oh, actually, that's $4 or $5 or whatever it is. We didn't know here in Canada, whatever's on the label is what they have to sell it for. In Australia, if something has the wrong price sticker on it, they'll tell you at the counter and charge you what it's supposed to cost. So that's a little bit different. But anyway, $0 went to the counter, and she just said, yep, we're getting that out of the system, and just scanned it, and it didn't cost us a cent. So I asked about this a couple of days later, and apparently there are certain games that they can't sell. Usually they give them away to charities and things like that, but for whatever case, occasionally sometimes they end up on the store shelf, and this is one of them. So for whatever reason, I'm not sure why, because I mean, like, it's published by Namco, but they can no longer sell this game to make money off it. So that's why it was $0, and you know, once again, I know it's a very mediocre game, but who can argue with free? Nobody, that's who. And now we're on the last games of the month. These are the Xbox One. There's only two of them. I don't pick up Xbox One games very much because the prices are still relatively high. Even though I've had the system for over a year, I only have about 5 games. Anyway, I was surprised to see Watch Dogs is now only $9. I know this is a game that disappointed a lot of people. From what I've seen, it doesn't necessarily look like it was a bad game or anything like that, but it was one of those cases of like a crazy amount of hype and just people get swept up in the hype, and of course it didn't live up to those expectations. You know, $9 for a game like this, like, I'm sure it's well made, I'm sure it runs well. Despite all of Ubisoft's problems, they don't make bad games, they just have a habit of following the one template a little bit too closely. So, you know, I don't have any expectations for Watch Dogs, so I doubt I'll be disappointed in it, and especially not for $9. So that was one of the Xbox One games I picked up. And the other was a treat for myself, that was Far Cry 4. Because of Christmas, I got given a couple of gift vouchers, and instead of buying a bunch of shitty games like I normally would if I had $25 spare, I decided to get something I actually wanted to play, and I'm a big fan of Far Cry. I love Far Cry 3. Far Cry 2, I didn't finish, but I'm hoping to go back to it this year and actually replay from start to finish and actually finish it this time. I love Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon, and I'm looking forward to Far Cry Primal. I think that looks really cool too, and yeah, I've been wanting to play this since it came out. I'm not going to play it until I play through Far Cry 2 and replay Far Cry 3. But yeah, I wanted to, it was a gift, so I wanted to get something I actually wanted for with it. And yeah, Far Cry 4 is the game that I chose for that. It's still $25, but considering it's only a year old, and unlike Watch Dogs, didn't upset a whole bunch of people, because I think they came out the same year. Yeah, I'm glad to have it in my collection. So, that is my January, my December-January pickups. These videos probably won't be this long, generally, because I don't pick up that many games, but because it was the holidays and I had a little extra cash floating about it, that's why I had more games than I normally would. But thank you again for joining me. Sorry that there was no pre-footage of me thrifting, but like I said, if I don't thrift, I can't do that, obviously. So yeah, thank you for your time. I hope you'll join me for my Nuzlocke challenge. Just a little more on that. It will be heavily edited because I don't want to be dragging out for ages in terms of like just boring stuff. And I want to start like putting, even though videos on this channel won't be super frequent, I want them to look good at least and have some like decent editing and, you know, be visually stimulating. So they'll, even in this video, I'll see a little bit of that with information of the games coming up on the screen and stuff, which I haven't done before, but I want to do going forward just to keep my editing skills fresh while I'm doing other projects. And yeah, so thank you again for joining me. I hope you'll join me for Pokemon Nuzlocke, and I hope you'll join me next month for my February pickups, whatever those may be. So until then, I hope you have a great day, and I'll catch you next time. Peace out.